Hi everyone, we're here at DevOx 2014 in beautiful Antwerp, Belgium. It's kind of cold today, actually. and I'm here with my guest to talk about Chrome apps everywhere, and maybe you can introduce yourself.
Sure, so my name's Andrew Grieve, and I work on the Chrome apps for mobile project. I've been doing web development for the past 6 years at Google, and it's always an exciting time.
Yeah, the web is an exciting place, and it's always a good time to be developing for the web. So Chrome apps and mobile, so these are probably two things we'll talk about. The first one, Chrome apps, can you maybe redefine this for those that haven't heard of it or need a refresh? How do they differ from web pages or web extensions?
Sure. So Chrome apps have had is actually a fairly short history. As we know them today for desktop, they were only made available late 2012, so only a couple years old. And the big difference from web pages is really that they don't run within a browser tab, so they have to run in their own window, and this distinguishes them from regular web apps. So you get them through the Chrome Web Store, they are downloaded and installed, and the main reason why you'd want them over a regular web app is that they have permission to use more powerful APIs, so things like the user's identity, raw sockets, or synced storage, some really more powerful and compelling APIs.
So there are two things you mentioned. The first is the actual its own Windows. It probably means it can be totally immersive, and you don't really know it is powered by a web engine or rendering engine.
Right, that's right.
Maybe you want to comment about that. And the second question is about the security aspect. It is very secure, though. Although it has those additional powers and APIs and to access the hardware and all of that, it is very secure at the same time. So maybe you want to comment on those two things.
Yeah. So as you were saying, like, not only do they run outside of a tab, but they run as their own window and separate from the browser. So that means they have their own desktop icon. They have their own alt tab, entry. And to most users, they'd be really hard-pressed to figure out that they were built on web technology.
Yeah, there's native integration with the OS, whichever OS that is.
Exactly. And as far as security goes, you also are right on point there as well, that in general, they are more secure than typical desktop applications. A large part of that is just because it's built by the Chrome team, and I've really never been on a team more paranoid, I guess, about security than the Chrome team. So, all the apps run in sandboxes, and there's really locked down capabilities of what they can do.
So there's a content security policy that's you need to have one. You can't run without one. Like a regular website could, but a Chrome app cannot.
Right. So content security policy is a fairly new HTML5 kind of API that's come out, and it is available for use on the open web. But it's an opt-in thing. So for Chrome apps, the difference is it's not opt-in. You must use it, and it really just helps prevent mostly against XSS attacks. And that's the rationale there is really just because we're giving you these more capable and powerful APIs, so the risk is kind of even greater to attacks.
And part of the new thing, so Chrome apps have been out for a little while already. We have good examples of popular apps that have been built and that people are using. But what is new, I would think, is the ability to build mobile apps nowadays with the same technology. Oh, and by the way, Chrome apps are being built with web technologies, as I think people have understood by now. It's all about JavaScript, HTML5, CSS. So take those skills that you have, those tools that you have to build desktop-like apps, but also mobile apps nowadays. So how does that work?
Right. So that is what I'm more intimately familiar with. That's what I've been working on for the past 2 years. So Chrome apps for mobile is actually just still in a developer preview phase. So there are some, I think, pretty compelling apps being built with it currently, but it's still hot off the press. And you can mostly think of that as a Cordova application. There's not a huge difference between a Chrome app for mobile application and a regular Apache Cordova application. So Apache Cordova is a fairly long-lived project which makes it easy to create HTML and JavaScript applications and deploy them to mobile platforms as native, as true native apps, you know, but built with web technology.
So how would that differ from me building, say, an Android native app using a web view?
So it actually wouldn't differ all that much. So Cordova applications in general are a web view taking up the entire page and rendering your UI that way. So the biggest difference I would say is it provides an abstraction that lets you target multiple platforms. So iOS, Android is what we support on Chrome apps for mobile. And then Cordova itself supports pretty much every mobile operating system that you can think of.
But you need to like develop to some very lowest common denominator in terms of what a web view can support. I know one of the nice very new features I believe in Android is the fact that the Chromium web view is now something that is being updated on a very regular basis. It's been like externalized.
Right.
You can take benefits of having like WebGL in the Chrome web view on Android. You may not be able to do this on all the platforms. So how does the developer deal with that?
Yeah, so this was historically a really kind of growing problem for the project for a long time, and it's only recently kind of been addressed in a meaningful way. So I'm really happy to say that there is a meaningful answer here. So like you said, as with Android L, the system web view is based on Chromium, I believe M37 at launch, and it is updatable outside of Android updates. So that's awesome. The iOS web view, as of iOS 8, they came up with a brand new web view. Now it has accelerated JavaScript and WebGL as well. So very capable there. And iOS, system updates are quite well adopted. Of course, the question still is, what about people that aren't running Android L, which has been, out for approximately one day now. So our answer, at least there, is the Intel Crosswalk open source project, which is a bundling of the Chromium web view inside your application. Okay. So there's a couple trade-offs, namely the size of it. It adds about 17 megabytes to your APK size. But for most, we haven't heard that this is actually a big problem, and it lets you use the latest and greatest web view on all Android targets.
So walk us maybe a little bit through the workflow, the tooling, the APIs. I want to start my Hello World and probably move a little bit beyond that and build my first Chrome app-based mobile app. What does it take?
Yep, so there's a couple of options there. I'd say the easiest just for building a Hello World and toying around a little bit is to use the Chrome Dev Editor. So this is, again, a project that was announced at the last Google I.O. this summer. And it's an IDE, which is actually built as a Chrome app itself. So that's kind of cool as a technology demonstration. But it's an IDE just for building Chrome apps. And so, there's templates in there. There's a play button. If you click play, it'll open your application as a desktop Chrome app. And then if you use the drop-down menu in our companion tool, the Chrome App Developer tool for mobile, then there's a deploy to mobile device button. So you can easily, without installing any SDKs, play around with what your app would look like both on mobile and on desktop.
Yeah, so the time to Hello World is very short in this case. I mean, no SDK,
That's the quickest path to a Hello World for sure.
Okay. So and eventually I do build this awesome app, and I just package this and distribute this through the traditional Play Stores or Apple Stores, right? That's how it works.
Yeah, for mobile, exactly. So the App Store on iOS or the Play Store on Android. Once you get past your typical Hello World, you want to install our command line tools. So we have Cordova's tools are based on Node.js, and so as are ours for Chrome Apps for Mobile. And we give you a kind of a Ruby on Rails style
scaffolding,
exactly. You can do CCA is the name of the tool, so CCA create project, CCA build Android, and that's about the extent of it. So you need to install your SDKs at this point for this tool, but then we give you a nice wrapper around them to just say, CCA build Android, CCA build iOS, and then that's what you upload to the stores.
And I'm pretty sure having command line also helps with continuous integration and integrating this in any build environment that. And development environment that developers have.
Yeah.
So web developers love using frameworks or libraries, whatever you want to call them. Does Chrome Apps recommend against or to use some libraries, if any, especially in the mobile case?
That's mostly a question we try to stay out of a little bit. There's new frameworks popping up all the time, and our project goal is to give you the awesomest, most powerful blank canvas to work with as possible.
Right, so you're not mandating anything.
Exactly. So Polymer, I think, is a promising project. Angular, I've had good times with. Ionic is a really popular Angular-based framework for Cordova-based applications, which works just fine for Chrome apps for mobile. Right. But I'd say, my personal little advice is to spend the time to at least understand what these frameworks are doing. But I wouldn't say I have a strong preference for any of them.
Choice is good.
Yep.
I like choice. So maybe to close off, you're here presenting at DevOx, and I think you also have some tips or information about what kind of paradigm works for developers, maybe in mobile apps, the things that really work well, things that don't work all that well, that people shouldn't maybe use yet or at all because it's just not the way they should build things in this environment. Do you want to tell us more about this?
I do have kind of developer guidance, I would say, tips and tricks in my talk. Mostly I'd say what works well is just, the main thing I find is just make sure you have that fast feedback loop when you're developing, and that's kind of one of the best things about developing for the web platform wherever you are. So for Cordova applications, the main trick there is to remember that you're building using web, so it doesn't take much to make your mobile application run on a desktop browser. And Chrome DevTools, emulation mode gives you a really easy way to, make Chrome pretend like it's a mobile device and shrink your viewport and whatnot. It's really fast and convenient. So it's no replacement for testing on device, but it certainly makes for a compelling workflow.
Great. So what is the status of this project altogether? Can people use it today? And would you recommend people shipping apps built on top of that, like today?
Yeah, so I'd say every application has different requirements. Certainly for some, this would be a perfectly reasonable platform to use today. There are some rough edges around us finishing up the crosswalk integration, for example. And we haven't yet updated CCA to support the iPhone 6 Plus icon sizes. So we'll have that done probably next week, some rough edges. But I'd say, for the most part, we're ready. We respond quickly to our bug tracker on GitHub.
And this is a good time to mention that this is a fully open source project, so people want to support, help, or at least know what's going on, it's done in the open.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you, Andrew. That's, I guess, all the time we have for. So thank you for answering my questions, and we'll be seeing you soon, online probably.
All right, thanks.